Welcome back. In this video, we'll be talking about the basic types that are built into the Python language. If you're coming from something like C or Java, you might be surprised by the things that are available in Python in the standard language. Java has lots of types that are built in, but they're part of the standard library. Python has a bunch of things built into the language itself. First couple of types are ones that you've already seen. We have integers. So for integers, they're just things like 1, 2, 17, negative 3. Nothing particularly remarkable about that. They have strings. So strings are things like ABC or the empty string. That's a string of length 0. One of the things that may be surprising, depending on what language you're coming from, Python will allow you to define your strings with double quotes or with single quotes. So this ABC, this ABC is exactly the same as this ABC. Python doesn't care about the difference between single and double quotes. We'll talk later about more advanced forms for strings, but that's a good place for us to get started. All right, arrays. Now, officially in Python, we call these lists. However, everybody else in the whole wide world, all the other languages, call these things arrays. So if you look up the formal Python documentation, you're going to see the word list, and I may sometimes talk about a Python list. But in this class, we're going to introduce a new data structure called a linked list, which is very different. So we're going to try to move away from that term and call these arrays. Now, what is an array? Well, an array is, I shouldn't put this over here where it looks like it's part of the syntax. I'll draw it over here. An array is a line of boxes all in a row that can hold various values. 3, 17, I'll put the word foo in here, and this can be 0. One of the things to notice about Python arrays, as I did here, is that it is possible to store a mix of different values inside an array. Depending on your program design, it might or might not be a good idea, but Python is perfectly comfortable with you doing it. The characteristics of an array, of course, is that because they're all in a row, it's very, very fast to jump to any given element. So we can say, if I want element 0, I can just access element 0. This is bracket 1, close bracket. This is bracket 3, and so on. How do you declare an array? Well, you can declare an array in Python by literally writing an open bracket and then writing a sequence of values separated by commas. So this is 3, 17, string foo, and then 0. 3, comma, 17, comma, string, foo, comma, 0. There you have it. You can have empty brackets. That means an empty array. And there's a whole bunch of operators that you can do on arrays, which we'll talk about a little bit later. Python also has tuples. Now, if you get down into the guts, there's more to know than I'm going to tell you here. But right now, you can just think of this as a read-only array. So it has the same physical structure in memory, but the way you declare it is that instead of having square brackets, you're going to use parentheses. So this would be 3, 17, foo, 0. And that is a tuple that has 4 elements in it. If you want to declare an empty tuple, because parentheses are very often used for other things, you can do that with paren, comma, paren. That is, well, that's a weird looking closed paren. That is a tuple that has zero elements. If you want to have something that has exactly one element, you can say string solo, comma, and this is a, so this is a tuple with one element. This is a tuple with four elements. This is a tuple with exactly zero elements. So this works exactly like an array, except that you can't change what's inside of it. The last one we're going to look at. Now there are more that Python has, but I want this is the last one that I want to show you in this video is a dictionary. If you're coming from Java, you've seen a hash map. This is the same thing. Sometimes this is called an associative array in some languages. If you're coming from JavaScript, objects in JavaScript are basically dictionaries. So you're gonna see, it's gonna be very familiar to you. It's not totally the same as how JavaScript does it, but pretty much. The idea of a dictionary is that it takes keys. Keys are input values, and it maps them to values. So instead of having things arranged in a line like this, like we have in an array, instead what we have is a whole bunch of correlations. So we could say that 3 maps to foo, and that negative 10 maps to bar. And if you're asking, hey, does Python allow you to mix types? Can you have different types for the keys and values? You can, just like in arrays. Same sort of statement is, it's debatable whether it's a great idea, but it's possible. All right, so if you've got a dictionary, how are you going to do this? Well, the first thing that you might do, a very common thing that you might do, is you might declare an empty array first. So you declare an empty array with empty curly braces. And once you do that, you can then access the elements of an array with, or the elements of a dictionary using array syntax. So you could say, if X is the empty array, then you could say X3 is equal to the string foo. So this is saying, I apologize that we're filling up the board here a little bit, but this says X is an empty array. Then this says map the key 3 to the value foo. The other thing you can do is that you can write a dictionary as a constant. So let's take this dictionary, 3 maps to foo, 10 maps to bar. To do that, we would do open curly brace, 3 colon foo comma negative 10 maps to bar, negative 10 colon bar. So this is a dictionary that contains two values. So you could say X equals this code, and what you'd have is a dictionary that has two values. Let's actually show that live. Let's show the dictionary. All right, so I've written here, X equals 3 colon foo, negative 10 colon bar. Can we print? Let's actually do first, let's say Y equals X 3, and then we'll print Y. Let's see what happens. It prints foo, because when you go to X 3, what it does is it looks for the key 3, finds the value foo, and it set that into Y and then printed it out. Of course, we can print it directly. So this first one is printing Y, the second one is printing X3. Can we print the dictionary itself? Yes, we can. Python will happily do that. And what you'll see here is that it uses, when it prints it out, it uses that same syntax that I used up here. Python prefers, when it prints things out, to use single quotes, and it did a little bit different with white space inside the declaration, but It all works the same basic way. We can add new values to it. So let's update something. We'll say x4 is equal to ASDF. And then let's change 3. x3 is equal to changed. What happens if we now print x? When we run it, what we see is that 3 now maps to the string changed, negative 10 still maps to bar, 4 maps to ASDF. So we'll show a lot more about what you can do with all of these types in future videos, but this is the basic introduction to the most important types that you'll be using in this class. Bye-bye.